Hi there folks, this particular video is dedicated to my son who asked me the question this morning, is it possible to create an automation that can duplicate a worksheet within an Excel workbook? And of course the answer is yes you can with Office scripts and Power Automate Cloud Flows. So this is very much a beginner video. I'm going to show you how to build that from scratch and hopefully by the end of it you'll be able to save some valuable time on those monotonous tasks and using Cloud Flows combined with Office scripts. So if we have a look at the screen right now, you can see that I've already got my timesheet open. Yes, he is complaining about submitting regular timesheets in Excel, and his task is to right-click on that template, hit the duplicate, and then go and rename that particular tab to, for instance, the beginning of a period, the 11th of January 2025, and then maybe go and update the text here as well. So we'll change that to 11th of January, 2025. And I can imagine that if you had a whole squad of people and you were doing this often, not only is there an opportunity for Power Apps, but there is also an opportunity for automation. And that's what we're looking at right now. So if we delete this, we'll start looking at how to build a script to achieve exactly those steps. So if we look at the top of the navigation bar of Excel, there is an Automate tab, and that Automate tab is currently only available in the online version of Excel. If you're in the online version and you can't see that tab, then you might need to go and speak to your IT administrator to enable it for you. Then, looking over on the left-hand side, we have a Record Actions button, and if I click on that, it pops open a panel over on the right-hand side, which is recording anything that I now do within this Excel workbook. As before, I'm going to right-click on that template and hit Duplicate, and we'll see already it's captured a step duplicating that worksheet template. Then, as before, I'm going to double-click, and I'm going to rename that worksheet to 11th of January 2025. Another step has been captured. Then I'll go into that text string and update it to 11th of January, and you'll see it's captured the fact that I have updated a cell range because it's submerged cells. Next stop is to jump up to the top right-hand side and to hit the stop button so that anything else that I do on this worksheet is no longer captured. If you've got different requirements, then you can go and record those additional steps. Equally, if you're just trying to explore what's possible with this recording tool, then go away, record all those actions, and you can have a look at the possibility of playing that back. Down at the bottom left, I'm going to right-click and delete that sheet that I've just created manually, and you'll see, as well as the steps that have been captured, the duplicate, the rename, and the edit, we have a run button. And if I hit that run button on the left-hand side, that worksheet is created automatically using that new script, which is fantastic, but at the same time, the values for the sheet name and also the text are fixed. So every time we run that, it's going to duplicate exactly the same thing. And obviously we want to be able to make some of that content dynamic. So this is where things get a bit more interesting, a bit more daunting, but I'll work you through it and hopefully you can learn with me. We'll click on the three dots and we'll go into Advanced Edit and switch into this Advanced Editing, and you'll see that we have some coding language. This is called TypeScript or Office scripts. And whilst it looks quite daunting, it's very easy for us to learn and change and even use Copilot if you have the free version of Copilot up in your right-hand side of your browser, maybe even ChatGPT. So looking at this code, what it's doing is, first of all, it is setting a variable. So every time you see let something equal to something, it is setting a variable within that code to the outcome. And the outcome in this case is get the active worksheet. So if you think about when you're using Excel day to day, the current active worksheet that I have open here is the 11th of January 2025. So if this code was to run now, it would get the 11th of January 2025 sheet as the active sheet. But actually, the template worksheet is the sheet that I always wanted to get. So even if someone's been poking around in this Excel file, I always wanted to get the sheet called template. So this is where I'm going to make the first change. I'm going to remove the text for get active worksheet. If I remove the dot and then re-add the dot, I can type in get worksheet using tab to autocomplete that text. add in some opening and closing brackets, you'll see I've still got an error message because it's waiting now for double quotes and then the name of the worksheet that it wants me to get. So I'm going to tell it to get the template worksheet, and it will save the result in a variable called selected sheet. That's line 2 of our code. On line 3, we have some comments, duplicate worksheet. And you'll see we have on line 4 another variable, let the template underscore underscore 2 underscore equal the selected sheet, which is our template worksheet, and copy it before the selected sheet. Now, the only thing I want to do here is I'd like to rename this variable because template underscore 2 is not very friendly. And what this is doing is it is creating our duplicate worksheet or our new sheet. So I'm actually going to call this new sheet. And you'll note then that I'm starting to get an error because where that new sheet variable has been referenced, it's no longer called template underscore 2 underscore. It's now called new sheet. So we can update that so everything matches and there are no more errors. So line 4, it has created a new sheet based on the selected sheet. It's a copy. It's inserting it before the selected sheet. And then on line 5, we're renaming the worksheet to a fixed string, the 11th of January 2025. So we can change that maybe to rename worksheet, not specifically to the text. Remember, this is just comments within the code to help you understand. The actual expression is new sheet.setName and then this string in quotes. So I'm going to keep it as a fixed value. We'll just call it Damien's test. And we'll look at making it dynamic later on in the video demonstration. Next up, on line 7, we are using another let to set a variable equal to the worksheet that is called 11th of January 2025. Now, this is maybe one of the advantages or disadvantages of using the recording tool. This line, I believe, is not required, and I'll explain to you why. We have already used new sheet as a variable to set the name. And we now want to use new sheet to set the value of a range. So rather than define a new variable for the worksheet that is called, in this case, 11th of January 2025, or Damien's test, we can actually get rid of line 7 entirely because it's no longer required. You'll note that I start getting an error message because, of course, it can't find that variable that we had previously defined, but we know that we're actually wanting to update the new sheet, the range being F7 to G7, and we want to set the value of that range to this string, week beginning 11th of January 2025. But I'm going to change this string for the purpose of demonstration to week beginning hyphen Damien's test. So that's the changes made to the office script that I want to make. I want to rename this script too. So we'll call this duplicate worksheet, like so. And then all that's left to do is to hit the play button so that we can run the script, paying particular attention to the bottom left-hand corner. So I'll hit run and we'll see that we now have a Damien's test sheet that's been created and the text has been updated to week beginning Damien's test. So we now have a working office script. We're now passing fixed values into that office script and we've tidied things up and understood what that code does. What I want to do now is demonstrate how to add in input parameters into this script that we can use when we run the script. And the advantage of adding in input parameters is that we can also pass them in via a cloud flow, something that we'll do later on in the video. So you'll see that I've inserted my cursor after the word workbook on line 1. I'll put in a comma and add in a couple of return lines, and that's just making space for our new input parameters. I'm going to call them sheet name, and after the name of the input parameter, you put in a colon followed by the data type. So you could add in string, you could add in number, and you can define different types if you're looking to get more advanced, like an array or something like that, something that I demonstrate in other videos that I have on my channel. If I add in a comma, I can add in a return line, and then we can pass in the sheet text as well. So where I've included week beginning Damien's test, I can now pass that in as a dynamic string. And again, defining the data type, everything is happy. We now have these two input parameters. So jumping down onto line 9, where I have the fixed string, Damien's test, I can now add in this new input parameter called sheet name. And where I have the set value, week beginning, Damien's test, again, I can add in or replace that string with the sheet text. And with that complete, when I hit the run button, you'll notice a change in behavior. I'm now being asked to complete these two input parameters, the sheet name, which I'm going to call demo test number 2, and the sheet text is this is demo number 2 test. And I'll hit the run button. So the script will accept those two input parameters, and you'll see that my tab has been created as demo test 2, and you'll see that the text is called this is demo number 2 test. So we now have a script that not only can we run manually from our Excel file, we can pass in input parameters. It's now ready for us to call from a cloud flow and pass in these values dynamically. But just before we jump across onto Power Automate, make sure that you have saved this script, because at the moment I have unsaved changes. So I'll click on that Save Script button. I have the tick, everything is updated, and we're now ready to jump across onto Power Automate. Over on Power Automate, I'm going to create a brand new flow. This is going to be a very basic flow. I could use an instant cloud flow for the purpose of testing, and equally, maybe even a scheduled cloud flow. So I'll go with a scheduled cloud flow, and we can call this create duplicate sheet. And we can choose a start date. Now it might be that we want this to happen every Monday morning. So I could choose the 13th, a specific time of day, whenever I want that automation to happen, maybe when I'm still tucked up in bed at 5 a.m. And then how often I want it to repeat. So not once every minute, but maybe once every week, specifically on that Monday. So I can remove all the other days there so that it runs every Monday, starting from 5 a.m. on the 13th of January. Perfect. I will get a new sheet every Monday morning. So we can create that, and the recurrence trigger is added and all those settings are configured for us. Next up is really just to run that script action. And if you're thinking, how are we going to test this? Because we're going to have to wait a week for this to happen. You can actually run your recurrence triggers manually as well. So we have that option. So I'll choose the run script. And I can then go through choosing OneDrive for Business, the particular document library, and then the file in question, which is my weekly timesheet that I have here. Then we choose a script, which is my duplicate worksheet script that I created earlier. And you'll see that it has two script parameters, the sheet name and the sheet text. The eagle-eyed might have also noticed that when I looked for run script, there was both a run script and a run script with SharePoint. Office scripts by default are shared on OneDrive and you use this default action here. But if you're looking to share them across wider teams and you save them in SharePoint, then there is that other action available too. So the sheet name, all I'm going to do is add in a value here. And in fact, just to make things interesting, let's make it dynamic. So if we click on the FX, we can make this dynamic, and I'm going to use UTC now. And I know that's going to output the date in a particular format. I would actually like it to be in a specific format. So in single quotes, because we're now in Power Automate, if I use lowercase d for days, that'll give me two numbers for days. If I use uppercase m's for month, two m's are just the number, three m's are the short version, and four m's are the full string. So January will be January in this case, because I've put four m's. And then the year, let's just have 25, so two lowercase y's. That'll give me a dynamic date that's calculated every time this flow is run by our recurrence trigger. The sheet name, I could combine both a fixed string and a dynamic value. The sample template had week beginning and then followed by the date. Again, we could click into FX, but let's go and click into the original expression that I've created. I can highlight that, use Control C on my keyboard to copy it, then jump back into the sheet text and into FX and Control V to paste. I now have that same expression, and rather than having the full month, let's just have the shortened month with three letters, the three uppercase M's, and we'll hit add into our expression editor. So that is the flow built. There's nothing else to it. If I save this, we can run it manually and we can actually see if we've managed to create a new sheet using our newly created Cloudflow automation. So that's it all set up, ready to test. I can manually run it. Like I say, the recurrence will run on a schedule, but you can still manually test it here from the test pane. We can run that flow. Looks like it's triggered. I'll jump back across onto that weekly timesheet and keep my eyes open for the bottom here where I'm expecting a new sheet to appear any second. And just like magic, we can see we have that newly created sheet called 11 January 25. And if we have a look at the text here, week beginning 11 Jan 25. So using the formatting within UTC now, you can see we have the long version of January in the sheet name and the short name in the text that we've supplied. And jumping back over onto our Power Automate, we can see that our automation has completed. We have now successfully created an automation that will duplicate a worksheet in a workbook using Office scripts and Cloud Flows to fully automate it based on a time schedule. And then finally, I'd just like to thank the 7 people that are supporting my channel through my $2.99 membership. But if you're looking to get access to a community, a forum, some courses, stuff that's not available to the normal members of my channel or even those that are subscribed, I've recently launched a new platform on Teachable that will include fortnightly calls, live calls with me and yourselves as community members for those that subscribe, enabling you to watch me do live demonstrations, but also to showcase stuff that you've built or are in the process of building. There's a community forum so that if you've got any issues with your building, you can reach out to those within this new community to support you. And there are 2 courses, the first of which, Copilot Studio, I'm in the process of launching in January 2025. And I look to launch a Power Automate Cloud Flow course later this year. So by being a member of this community, details of which will be included in the description, you'll have access to those fortnightly calls, the 2 courses that I'm launching, and the community forum to discuss your needs with our newly launched group. Thanks very much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you again sometime soon. Cheers.